we are going to study a new topic, that is life cycle of nostoc. This nostoc is a very common colonial blue-green alga. Now in this life cycle study, we have to study taxonomic position, occurrence, callus structure, reproduction, and graphic cycle. For our convenience, we are starting with the first point, that is occurrence. Now, this nostoc is one of the most common blue-green alga, showing cosmopolitan occurrence. That means it occurs in all types of environment, in different parts of the world. It may be tropical, subtropical, temperate, including the Arctic and Alpine region. This alga is represented by means of 20 different species, and most of the species of this nostoc are free living and terrestrial, whereas some are aquatic in a habitat. So most of the species of nostoc are free living, terrestrial, or aquatic in a habitat, whereas some of the species of nostoc are growing as a endophyte, that means inside the body of other plant. Endo, that is inside, phyta, that is plant. So few species of nostoc occurs inside the body of other plants. It may be a endophytic plant, or it may be a bryophytic plant, or it may be a gymnosperm. For example, in case of bryophytic plant like Anthocyros, nostoc occurs in a mucilage cavities. In case of pteridophytes such as water fern, that is Azolla, this nostoc or Anabina usually occurs in this aquatic fern body. In case of gymnosperms like Cycas, you can have a growth of this nostoc just below the epidermal layer, forming a distinct zone that is called as algal zone, and it is present in a coronoid root. So in case of coronoid roots of Cycas, you can have this nostoc which is growing as an endophyte. Whereas some of the species of nostoc are showing symbiotic association or symbiosis with fungi. So here nostoc plus a fungus usually results in formation of a new composite plant, which we refer it as lichen. So this nostoc which is represented by more than 23 species all over the world, in which most of the species are free living, growing on moist soil surfaces as terrestrial one, or some they are growing in a water bodies that are called as aquatic. Whereas few species they are growing inside the body of other plants, and that is called as endophyte. Some common examples of endophytic nostoc is observed in a mucilaginous cavities of Anthocereus thallus, which is a bryophyte. In case of water pond, that is Azolla, that is a pteridophyte. And in case of purulite roots of cycas, you can have an endophytic growth of nostoc. Whereas another and a very important habitat that is commonly associated with the few species of nostoc is a symbiosis or symbiotic association. And this nostoc usually forms a symbiotic association with fungus, and it leads into the development of a composite organism, which we refer it as a lichen, that shows a distinct body and other characters, not identical with nostoc or not with the fungus. So this is about the occurrence of the nostoc. Out of these 23 different species of nostoc, some species of nostoc that are commonly occurring in India, and the most common Indian species includes nostoc punctiforme, then nostoc comini, then nostoc cornum, nostoc endophytum, and so on. So these are the most common Indian species of nostoc. The next point is a thallus structure. As I told you that this leaf green alga is a very common and colonial alga. Now you can observe the small spherical structures that are usually observed on the moist soil surface during rainy season in our area, and this is nothing but it is the colony of nostoc. Now this colony of nostoc ranges from microscopic in size, that means it is a very small in size that cannot observe by means of unaided eye, and therefore it is called as a microscopic. And largest size of this colony measures about 8 centimeter in diameter. So the size of colony of nostoc is from small microscopic to a large, which ranges or measures up to 8 centimeter in a diameter. Our diameters are called as, so just 8 centimeter evda usushit. Now this colony has a definite shape in a most of the cases, or if a colony is young, and it is somewhat spherical or ball like, and therefore this ball like spherical colony is commonly called as a nostoc ball. Kalapa nostoc ball manto karaka tatasa akar jo hai size वेरिएबल आहे, परंतु शेप जो आहे तो स्फेरिकल आहे, आणि तो स्फेरिकल असल्यामुळे बॉल सारखा दिसतो आणि त्यामुळे ह्या कॉलनीला नॉस्टॉक बॉल असं म्हटलं जातं. नाउ इन सम केसेस हियर यू कॅन हॅव ए अनदर टाइप ऑफ थॅलस अँड द थॅलस ऑर कॉलनी इज इरेग्युलर इन सेल ऑर इट मे apparently looks like a jelly-like structure. That means the shape is not definite. So in most of the cases, the colony is having a definite shape, which is a spherical one or round one, looking like a ball, and therefore it is called as nostoc ball. In some cases, towards the maturity, the shape of this ball get altered and it becomes flat. And you can say it as an irregular shaped colony or jelly like structure. And the color of this colony ranges from olive green to blue green. Now this color is either olive green or it may be blue green. And this intensity of color that varies from olive green to blue green depends upon the intensity of sunlight to which this alga is exposed. So this color intensity depends upon the exposure of this alga to the sunlight. Now each colony, if you observe, is a hollow. That means this colony has such a definite gelatinous membrane that includes a matrix, and this gelatinous matrix usually shows presence of numerous thousands of these small unbranched microscopic filaments or trichomes. If you observe this internal structure of colony, which has a definite wall, a mass of gelatinous matrix in which numerous or thousands of trichomes they are distributed, and the distribution is so peculiar that here most of the trichomes or filaments are crowded towards the periphery of spherical structure, and at center you can have a space. So you can say it as a hollow colony. It is a hollow colony. Now this is about the structure of colony. If you observe a single trichome or filament of this nostoc under microscope at a high magnification, you can observe here many such rounded cells. They are arranged one above the other, forming a single row that is called as uniform seam, and it is called as trichome. Each trichome has its own mucilage sheath. Now here in this blue green algae, the mucilage sheath that is present to this structure or thallus is shown by means of dotted line. So this is mission is sheath, which is the mucilage sheath of the trichome itself. In addition to this, the colony has a separate mucilage sheath, and this trichome itself is also having a mucilage sheath. Then each vegetative cell here, if you observe, is a having prokaryotic cell organization. That means you cannot observe a true nucleus. Instead, you can have such uniformly condensed granular cytoplasm in each vegetative cell, and the color of this vegetative cell is a blue green, mostly blue green, or it may be olive green in some cases. And due to this blue green color, each such vegetative cell is a photosynthetic in activity, and it produces food material by the process of photosynthesis. So whatever these granules that are present in the peripheral region of the vegetative cell is nothing but the food granules, and this food granule is mixophycian or cyanophycian starch. या ठिकाणी हे जे ग्रॅन्युल्स आहे व्हेजिटेटिव्ह सेलमध्ये, ते काय आहे, फूड मटेरियल आहे, आणि त्या फूड मटेरियलला एक तर हे लोक मिक्झोफायशियन स्टार्च असं म्हणतात किंवा सायनोफायशियन स्टार्च असं म्हणतात. अँड ड्यू टू दिस यू कॅन हॅव ए ग्रॅन्युलर अपिअरन्स. देन इफ यू ऑब्झर्व the cells of this trichome, which is characteristically unbranched, it is a unbranched, then as cells are rounded one and placed one above the other, these are attenuated, and in most of the species these are trichomes are bent or coiled spirally, and therefore they are called as contorted trichomes, or filaments are called as a contorted. Make clear that this is called as trichome because it doesn't have its own cell wall like that of other alga like spirogyra, which will refer it as a filament. So here there is a presence of mucilage sheath comparable with the own cell wall, but they cannot be considered as a true filament, and instead they are called as a trichome. So if you observe each trichome or filament, here it is a uniseriate or monouniform, unbranched, and they are contorted, that means they are spirally coiled or bent, and as each and every cell in this trichome, they are spherical, there is a presence of a notch here at the point of union of vegetative cell, and therefore it is called as attenuated trichome or filament. In addition to vegetative cell, this trichome shows presence of some specialized cells, and the position of these specialized cells may be intercalary or they may be at the end of trigone. So this is in between the fugitive cell, so it is said to be intercalary imposition, and this is present at one end and therefore it is called as a terminal. So such specialized intercalary or terminal specialized cells that are present in a nostoc filament or trichome is called as heterocyst, and according to the position of this heterocyst in the trichome, if it is intercalary in position, then it is called as intercalary heterocyst, and if it is present at the tip of trichome, it is called as a terminal heterocyst. If you observe the structure of heterocyst, which is a very special, here the cells of this specialized structure are comparatively slightly larger than that of the other fugitative cell. Then they are always colorless or haline. Here all the fugitative cells, they appears to be blue green or olive green due to presence of characteristic pigments of blue green algae present in all the vegetative cells. But here these heterocysts, it may be intercalary or terminal heterocyst, it is not having any chlorophyll or photosynthetic pigments, and therefore they appears to be haline or colorless. Instead, you can have a colorless content in this specialized cell, that is heterocyst. Then this heterocyst has two or one pore, that is called as polar nodule. Here it is called as a polar nodule. The number of polar nodule in a case of terminal heterocyst is one, and in case of intercalary heterocyst you can have two polar nodules. That means this polar nodule that is present in the wall of the heterocyst is indicating the sign of attachment with the other vegetative cell. Here it is present towards the end where it is attached to the vegetative cell and absent towards the terminal end. Here, as both the ends of this heterocyst being intercalary in position, you can have the two distinct polar nodules. Now here this specialized cell, which is called as heterocyst, is having a dense cytoplasm without photosynthetic pigments, but the main role of this specialized structure is in a nitrogen fixation. You are quite familiar with the fact that almost all blue green algal members has capacity to fix atmospheric or molecular nitrogen and convert it into the soluble forms of nitrogen, that is nitrites and nitrates. And this conversion of molecular nitrogen into nitrites and nitrates is being carried out due to presence of specific enzymes that are mostly present in a heterocyst. And therefore, here heterocyst is a site of nitrogen fixation. It doesn't mean that blue green algae without heterocyst are not nitrogen fixers. they can fix the nitrogen, but the efficiency of this structure in nitrogen fixation appears to be more than that of the ordinary vegetative cell. Besides that, this heterocysts also play important role in a vegetative and asexual reproduction. So this is about the structure of colony, structure of thallus, and structure of vegetative cell, as well as structure of heterocyst. And function of vegetative cell is a photosynthesis to produce food material in the form of exophycian or cyanophycian starch. And the main function of heterocyst, it is said to be nitrogen fixation. Besides that, it helps in the process of vegetative or asexual reproduction. Then next point is a reproduction. This most common colonial blue urine alga reproduces by means of vegetative and asexual reproduction. So in this alga you can have only vegetative and asexual reproduction, whereas sexual reproduction is totally absent. Sexual reproduction is totally absent. That is characteristic feature of blue-green algae, like that of prokaryotic cell organization. Here, absence of sexual reproduction is another important character of blue-green algae. And as Nostoc is one of the blue-green alga, here this sexual reproduction is totally absent. Then we have to study what are different methods of vegetative and asexual reproduction. The first and very common type of vegetative reproduction is a fragmentation. Here, this colony, which is of variable size, may get separated into small fragments or pieces. And whatever the small fragment or piece that is formed by the breaking of the colony has capacity to further develop into a large sized new colony, and this process is called as a fragmentation. Now this fragmentation is observed due to either mechanical injury or due to the some decomposition of older cells, or sometimes the gelatinous matrix or wall of the colony may get decomposed so as to form a small fragments. And this is a very common method of vegetative reproduction in this alga. The second type of reproduction, that is asexual reproduction, and this asexual reproduction takes place by means of special methods. It may be referred as a vegetative or asexual reproduction. In a thallus structure, we have studied that this nostoc is having such contorted type of trichomes or filaments. So in this process of vegetative or asexual reproduction, what happens? Sometimes this trichome get dissociated due to formation of the fragments. And this fragment formation may take place by two different means. Here, if there is a heterocyst, the connection of vegetative cell with heterocyst is a comparatively weaker as compared to the junction that exists between the two vegetative cells. So here you can have the separation of vegetative cell or groups of vegetative cells in a small fragment due to either the loose connection that may exist between heterocyst and vegetative cell, or sometimes this vegetative cell wall connection can dissociate and these two neighboring vegetative cells, they get separate from each other, and here also they get separate from each other, and this fragment of the trichome that is newly developed from the entire trichome is called as hermobone. So this hermobone that is developed from the trichome get expelled from this trichome, and even it get spelled out through the wall of colony, and each such hermobone germinate to produce a new filament, then number of filaments that are produced so as to form a new colony enclosed again in a gelatinous matrix. Then third type of reproduction that is observed in this Leucrine alga is by means of echinids. Now here the echinids are spatial resting structures. Visually they are produced up towards the approach of unfavorable condition. What happens? Any of the vegetative cell of this nostoc trichome when get exposed to the unfavorable condition usually accumulates the food material and whatever the content of the cell get condensed, and at the same time during this accumulation or condensation of the material inside this vegetative cell, the wall of this cell appears to be thicker. So thick wall is usually developed to these specialized cells. Now here this development of such thick walled cells during unfavorable condition may take place in isolated manner, or it may be observed in a groups of 2, 3, 4 that depends upon the species of nostoc. And any of the cell that is either away from heterocyst or next to heterocyst, you can have the development of such specialized cells which are called as echinids. Now as each of the echinid, here this is one echinid, this is second akinet, this is third akinet. Each akinet has a thick wall, then a condensed cytoplasm having sufficiently large amount of reserved material, then functional nucleus. When this entire trichome get exposed to unfavorable condition, what happens? All the vegetative cells, including heterocyst, usually desiccates, dry, and dies. Whereas, due to presence of such thick wall in these specialized akinets, they can survive from the unfavorable condition, and therefore they remains as a living, and therefore it is called as perinating structures rather than multiplication. And each such akinet, when exposed to the favorable condition, has capacity to develop into a new trichome of Nostoc. Then next type of reproduction is by means of germline. This germline formation is very common under certain environmental conditions in some of the species of trichome. Here, heterocyst, which is a specialized cell, the content of heterocyst get divides first into two daughter cells. Each daughter cell then divides so as to form two daughter cells. As a result of which, a short fragment or a short trichome is developed inside heterocyst, and as a result of the pressure that exerted by this developing trichome on the wall of heterocyst, rupture, and you can have such a small new trichome that is developed from the heterocyst itself, which is called as germline, and this germline later on develops into a new trichome or thallus of the nostoc. And last type of reproductive structure that is produced in a nostoc is endospore. Again, this endospore formation is very common in a species like Nostoc communia and Nostoc microscopica, in which the content of this heterocyst, which is a specialized vessel, divide, redivide, and produces a small spore-like structures, each having some cytoplasm, some reserved material, and the genetic material that is not a true nucleus but whatever it may be, DNA, RNA, or both. And as these are the spores that are developed inside this heterocyst cell, so they are called as endospores. And when these endospores they mature, usually the wall of heterocyst structure, and each endospore on liberation develops into a new trichome or filament of this nostoc. So this is about the vegetative and asexual reproduction in case of nostoc, which is takes place by means of five different methods. One that is fragmentation, second is by harmobunia, third one is by the germline, fourth one akinet, and fifth one is endospore. Then next one is a life cycle. If you observe graphic life cycle of nostoc, sexual reproduction is totally absent, but it reproduces by means of fragmentation. Then again it reproduces by means of harmobunia. Then third one is by means of akinets, Then fourth one is by germline. And fifth one is by endospores. And endospores again germinate to produce a nostoc colony. So this is about the graphic life cycle. In other algae, you can have additional sexual cycle in the life cycle, but being a bluegreenalgal member, here sexual reproduction is totally absent, and therefore you can't have the cycle on the lower side. The last point that we have to study in this life cycle is a taxonomic position. Now this bluegreen alga nostoc belongs to group algae, and you know the characters of algae that we have studied is a autotrophic calophyte. Autotrophic calophyte. Then this algae has been divided into different division by different workers, and this nostoc belongs to division cyanophyta, which is commonly called as a blue green algae. And this blue green color is due to presence of chlorophyll A. Then the very important C phycoerythrin, and there is a predominance of C phycocyanin, which is a blue color pigment that masks the green color and red color of phycoerythrin, and thallus appears to be blue green and commonly called as blue green. Then another characteristic feature is a prokaryotic organization, prokaryotic cell organization. In this class, division is further divided into a single class, that is a cyanophyce, commonly called as blue green algae, and here the characteristic feature is a cyanophycian starch is a reservoir material. Then this class has been further divided into different orders, and nostoc belongs to order nostocales. Then family nostocaceae, and genus nostoc. So this is about the classification or taxonomic position of nostoc, group algae, division cyanophyta, class cyanophyce, order nostocales, family nostocaceae, and genus nostoc. And this nostoc is also having economic importance. In countries like Brazil and some other countries, the colonies of nostoc are boiled or roasted and eaten as a food material. Then another economic importance of nostoc is it is a very important biofertilizer, as it has capacity to fix the molecular nitrogen and convert it into soluble forms of nitrogen. It is a very important biofertilizer, commonly and naturally growing in a paddy fields where you can have enough amount of water in the paddy field, but this can be added to other crops also as an important biofertilizer. So this is about the life cycle of nostoc, which is the very common and colonial blue green alga. Thank you.